There are many supplements and products for PCOS that include inositol, myo-inositol, and d-chiro-inositol. Some of them additionally include other ingredients like folic acid, vitamins, zinc, and other microelements. All of them promise to solve all your PCOS problems, but is it really worth a hype? Welcome to Holistic Ovaries. I am Agnese, and every week I post a new video about PCOS. So if you want to take informed decision about managing your PCOS symptoms, subscribe to the channel. In this video, we are going to talk what is inositol, what form of inositol is the best for women with PCOS, when to take it, what dose is optimal for us, and what to avoid when taking inositol supplement. So what is inositol and why it is important for us women with PCOS? Inositol refers to a group of molecules that are structurally similar to glucose and are involved in cellular signaling. Important organs such as brain and ovaries use high levels of inositol to efficiently carry its physiological functions. Women with PCOS have been found to have lower levels of inositol, including myo-inositol and d-chiro-inositol, compared with women without PCOS. Inositol acts as insulin-sensitizing agent and keep free radicals from damaging the cells, thus improving insulin resistance and ovarian function. Myo-inositol and d-chiro-inositol are specific forms of inositol. At the ovarian level, myo-inositol is involved in glucose uptake and FSH signaling. It means that myo-inositol helps ovaries to use FSH more effectively and improve ovulation and egg quality. It also helps the body to use insulin more efficiently, thus improving blood sugar levels. On the other hand, d-chiro-inositol is involved in insulin-mediated androgen production and improves insulin sensitivity in the liver and in the muscles. What would be the best form of inositol for PCOS? Many different studies have examined the best inositol form and combination for PCOS. It seems to me that many supplements providers choose randomly the ingredients and components and sometimes add useless or counterproductive components that can weaken myo-inositol efficacy. Clinical evidence has demonstrated that the ratio of 40:1 of myo-inositol and d-chiro-inositol is optimal to restore ovulation in PCOS women. Why this ratio 40:1? Because endogenous production of myo-inositol and d-chiro-inositol of women without PCOS is in ratio 40:1. It makes sense that we would like to restore optimal functioning of our ovaries. And more doesn't mean that it will work better or faster. In fact, it can be contrary. For example, d-chiro-inositol can be beneficial when administered in low doses. Yet, the progressive increase of its dosage can result in a loss of advantageous properties on reproductive system in women. Additionally, the intestinal absorption of myo-inositol is reduced when taken at the same time d-chiro-inositol because the two of them, they fight for the same transporter. So if you use combination of these two ingredients, it's better to have higher dose of myo-inositol. Additionally, the high doses of d-chiro-inositol can be harmful for the ovaries and egg maturation. And when to take inositol? In general, inositol can be taken with or without food. It should be taken at the same time each day to maintain consistent level of nutrients in the body. Research shows that for women with PCOS, it's the best to take inositol before bedtime. I myself take 2 grams of inositol in the morning with my breakfast and 2 grams of inositol in the evening, 30 minutes before I go to sleep. And for how long to take inositol? The studies have shown that to get benefits of inositol, it has to be taken between 12 to 16 weeks. But for some women, to maintain the benefits of inositol, it can be taken for months or even years. I myself take inositol already for 2 years. It doesn't have any side effects on me. And I believe that it really helps with my ovulation. And what to avoid when we take inositol. Many of you told me that inositol is not working for you, but did you know that if you take inositol with sugar, it might not be effective? But what kind of sugar we talk about? Sorbitol, maltodextrin, and sucralose. Those are that kind of sugars that can interfere with myo-inositol absorption. Sorbitol is a sugar alcohol that is commonly used in sugar-free products like gums and candies. It can also be found in fruits such as apricots, prunes, and nectarines. Maltodextrin is a carbohydrate that is often used as a thickener or filler in processed foods. It is also used in sports drinks and other supplements. Sucralose is an artificial sweetener and is often used as a substitute of sugar in a wide range of goods like soft drinks, baked goods, and candy. And what about inositol with additional ingredients like vitamins, zinc, or other microelements? My personal suggestion is to stick with one ingredient supplement as much as possible. Why? Because when you take one ingredient supplement, it is easier to notice if the supplement has any side effects, what it does to your body, what changes it makes to your mental health. It is easier to monitor what is going into your body, and it also helps to rotate the supplements or change the supplement. And this is a rational approach to supplementation. But in general, if your inositol have an extra vitamin D, alpha lipoic acid or folic acid, which is not necessary, but it will not do any harm. But if your inositol supplement have these ingredients, chlorazine, chlorogenic acid, and quercetin, be aware because they reduce inositol intestinal absorption. I know that this is a lot of information, so let's recap this. Recommended inositol is myo-inositol and d-chiro-inositol in ratio 40:1. But good alternative would be inositol or only myo-inositol. Taken 2 times a day at the same hours every day, best in the morning and in the evening, for minimum 12 weeks. Avoid taking inositol with sugars found in processed foods and avoid ingredients that can reduce inositol absorption. Remember that I have a free guide for you about hormonal testing for PCOS, and you can find the link in box description below. Comment, like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.